says, and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Slavery.
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
Wait, we just gonna walk over here.
With ships.
We gonna drive a car.
With ships.
We gonna get on a plane.
With ships.
Right? It said, we were going to Egypt into bondage and slavery again with ships.
It was what?
The earth is given to the hand of the wicked.
No, the righteous are in charge.
The earth is given to the hand of the wicked.
Read.
He calleth the faces of the judges thereof.
He do what?
He calleth the faces of the judges thereof.
Says, so the wicked is controlling the world right now, and they're covering the faces of the judges thereof. Our true judge is Hamashiach the Hawashai, who the world so ignorantly calls Jesus Christ.
That's right!
Verse 1.
Bring it out.
It said, and he answered me, saying, the Most High has made this world for many, but the world to come for few.
Now everybody gonna make it.
The world to come for few.
Hey, the world to come is for few, man. Right? Only a remnant is gonna wake up and turn back to the Lord in these last days.
That's right.
The world to come is for few, you know.
The sign of the Lord is gonna be from St. Louis to Los Angeles. Living in the lowest and the bottom of society. We still living in the lowest of the lowest people here in America. So it's like, that's another prophecy, right? So like, how did we get over here? How did they bring us over here? Right? Give me Deuteronomy 28:16. Nah, go ahead, give me Exodus 22.
Bring it on!
The
Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Right, so the Lord shall bring us into Egypt again, right? So the Israelites, at this time, they had just came out of slavery, right? That's what Moses parted the Red Sea, that's what all that was about. The Israelites getting out of Egyptian slavery, right? And also, if you look at Revelation 11:8, because this is, actually, matter of fact, bring that up.
This is the book of Exodus, chapter 20, chapter 20, verse 2.
Bring it out.
I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
Right? So Egypt is just synonymous with bondage, right? And when you read in Revelation 11 and 8, right, this land called Babylon the Great is actually in reference to spiritual Egypt and Sodom, right? Sodom and Gomorrah, meaning they was, back in Sodom and Gomorrah, they was, doing all this type of homosexual bullshit that was out there with, right? Kind of like how they was last week.
Just the whole month.
This is spiritual Sodom and Egypt, right? But in 28:68, it said, the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again, right? Go ahead.
It says, and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Slavery.
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
Wait, we just gonna walk over here.
With ships.
We gonna drive a car.
With ships.
We gonna get on a plane.
With ships.
Right? It said, we were going to Egypt into bondage and slavery again with ships.
Cargo slaves.
So what we're talking about, literal Egypt, because they walked out of Egypt. It's talking about another captivity, another slavery, right? And that prophecy was fulfilled with the transatlantic slave trade. You know what I'm saying? So that's how we see these prophecies come to pass, right? Go ahead, keep reading.
God. By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bond men and bond women.
Right? It said, by the way thereof, meaning the land which we got these laws, statutes, and commandments, we wouldn't see it again. We wouldn't see our homeland again. We wouldn't know who our customs were. We wouldn't know anything about what we came from. We've never seen our homeland. Right? And it said that when we got here,
be sold for linemen and bound.
That's slavery.
We'd be sold for slaves. Right? And read that, continue to read.
Come. It says, and no man shall buy you.
Right? No man shall buy you. That word buy in Hebrew and in the Mosaic law, when you have a slave, the slave can buy his way out of slavery. But it says, no man shall buy you, meaning no man shall redeem you, no man shall get you out of this captivity. Alright? You see that no man has gotten us out of this captivity. No man has brought us, no man, ain't nobody come to save us. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no so-called Africans came to save us. You know what I'm saying? As we just said, none of our prominent black leaders can save us. Right? So it's like, who else could this be talking about? Could this be talking about the so-called Ashkenazi Jews? Can't be talking about it. They ain't gonna do that. They never had to experience these things. You know what I'm saying? So that's only dealing with our people. And that's one of the reasons how we know that we're the people in this book. And when you really get into reading this book, and when you really get into studying this book, man, you start to see so many similarities between how we talk and speak and how this book is written. You know what I'm saying? This book is a poetic book. You feel me? It speaks in metaphors. You know what I'm saying? It speaks in certain points. It's got punchlines. All types of things. Right? And when you start to read this book, it's like, you know this book is dealing with all people.
Bring it out!
These people ain't that creative. You feel me? So look, let's find out another thing of who we are. Give me Deuteronomy 10, 26.
Wake them up!
26 and 18.
God, the book of Deuteronomy chapter 26 and verse 18. And the Lord have avouched thee this day to be his peculiar people, as he hath promised thee, and thou shalt slack it, and that thou shouldest keep all his commandments.
Right? So the Lord has chosen us to be his peculiar people, and we should keep all his commandments, because the Lord only gave one group of people his law, statutes, and commandments. Right? Go ahead and read on that.
Come.
Verse 19, and to make thee high above all nations which he had made.
Right? High above all nations, right? So we are the greatest people in the world. Right? Even though in our lower state, you can see our greatness shine through in the areas where we're allowed to shine through, right? Basketball, football, music, food that we cook, all of these things, dancing, you know what I'm saying? I'm just watching a video of some so-called black kids dancing today. I'm like, man, nobody else dance like us, right? The Memphis Jupiter, right? They're doing all them, you know what I'm saying? All that stuff, right? I'm like, man, can't nobody do that like us, right? So it's like, we're the greatest people in the world. And guess what? Everybody want to be like us too. Everybody around the world, like what's the saying that goes, right?
Book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 37.
Yeah.
And thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations which the Lord shall lead thee.
Right? So it said we should become a proverb and a byword among all nations, right? You know what the saying goes? Everybody want to be a nigga until it's time to be a nigga. You know what I'm saying? That's a proverb right there. That's a wise saying, right? Everybody want to be just like us, right? Which, that's another thing. We're an astonishment. Everybody is astonished at how we're able to dance as good as we do. The music that we make, all of the major music that came out of America came out of our people, right? Rock and roll, jazz, all the music that they love. You know what I'm saying? That they love now, that they took from us, claiming it as their own, that came from us, right? Chuck Berry, I believe, was from St. Louis. You know what I'm saying? He was a rock and roll artist. You feel me? So it was like, man, everybody want to be like this. You look over here. The oppressive thing, the slave master slavery. You know what I'm saying? You got to work from sun up to sundown, without pain. Right? The sugar fields and the cotton fields and out the right, tobacco fields, the corn fields. We got to work and do all these things every day with no pay. We don't get paid for it. No compensation. Right? That's a curse. Right? Even in modern times, right? You the last hire of the first father. Right? All of the highest paying jobs in America, one may not even present it to our people like that. Right? right? And the education to get into those things isn't really even marketable to us like that, right? We don't see our people at a high rate becoming engineers, right? Getting into tech, getting into the highest paying fields that America has to offer, right? And that's part of the reason why we're different. Like, we don't have access to the same resources, right? So look, let's figure out, man. Let's figure out what we're really supposed to be doing, right? Because the end is coming. The end of us being in captivity and the end of this world, the end of these people's kingdoms, right, is coming, right? I know you see everything about the wars over in Ukraine, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if you heard about, they talking about famine, supply chain is going out, that's going on inflation, that's going on aid for the famine. Right? Biden said that famine is a real thing. The whole family is a real thing, right? But hey, all of that, that's prophesied by Biden. How we know the Bible. Look, right? Go ahead and read that
book. Book of Deuteronomy chapter 10 and verse 12.
Bring it out!
And now Israel, what doeth the Lord thy God require of thee? But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways, and to love him, and to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul, to keep the commandments of the Lord and the statutes which I command thee this day for thy good.
It says that we're supposed to fear the Lord with all our heart and all our soul and keep the commandments, right? So if you love God, who the world calls God, his real name in the Paleo-Hebrew is Yahweh, right? And his son's name in the world called Jesus Christ is Yahweh. Right? So if we serve our God
with
all our heart and all our soul and to the best of our abilities, we're supposed to keep the commandments. Right? That's our duty. That's what our duty is. What's going on, brother?
I'm so glad I come back.
Right. So like, yeah. So we're supposed to be keeping the commandments, right?
We keep his commandments, and his commandments are not preach.
Right, so this is the love of God, is that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are hard to keep, right? Yeah, okay, we live in a spiritually lawless society, right? Where, yeah, we have laws, but as long as you stay within them laws, you can be as immoral as you want to be. You can live how you want to live, right? You can be a damn homosexual. You know what I'm saying? Your wife can commit adultery on you. She can go and sleep with any man that she wants to behind your back. She can have a baby on you and ended up paying child support for another man's child for 18 years. You know what I'm saying? Attorney to fry. Right? We live in a land where they can do all of these damn things to us and ain't no punishment for it, right? Right? It's a spiritual divorce. Right. So yeah, actually, yeah. Let's bring out commandment, right? Leviticus 11. So I'm right. Because the Lord calls us to live a certain way, and it's described specifically here in the Bible, right? So the Lord says it's certain things that we can eat and that we can't eat, right? Certain things are unclean. Certain things are abominations, right? The Lord wants to consume it. Right, so go ahead and bring that up.
Book of Leviticus chapter 11 and verse 7.
Bring it up!
And the swine, though he divide the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he chew it not the cud, he is unclean to you.
Right, so you know the pig, you know the swine, right? Yeah, it's a pig, right? So it says the pig is unclean to you, though he divide the hoof, and he has certain attributes of a pig, right? He don't chew the cud, right? Meaning he doesn't digest his food properly, to where we would be able to consume it, right? And plus a pig is eating your shoe, right? A pig on a farm, a pig just eats up the slop and all of the leftovers that we eat, okay? Right? Let's go ahead and keep it.
says, of their flesh shall ye not eat, and their carcass shall ye not touch. They are unclean to you.
Right, we ain't even supposed to touch it. Right, you see some bacon, you ain't even supposed to put your hands on it. Right? Like if you got a bacon, somebody put some bacon on the sandwich, man, you just gotta throw something. Right? So it's like we can't even touch it. So that's how unclean that is, right? And that's a high standard. That's a real high standard to the point, man, that thing is so dirty, man, you don't even want, we ain't even supposed to touch it. I don't even want to touch it, right? So why is it so, they tell you how dirty that thing really is, right? But yeah, it's a damn delicacy, right? They didn't trick us into eating chitlins, you know what I'm saying? I know your mama used to probably be cooking chitlins on Christmas morning, you know what I'm saying, cleaning the things out. She in that kitchen cleaning the things for 6 hours. Hey, nasty. Disgusting. It's sick, right? You wake up in the morning, you smell like, damn, spices. Go to the bathroom, mother. Nah, big mama in there cleaning out them chips. You know what I'm saying? Right? And go ahead and keep reading on us.
It says, verse 9, these shall you eat of all that are in the waters, whatsoever have fins and scales in the waters, in the seas and in the rivers, them shall ye eat. And all that have not fins and scales in the seas and in the rivers, of all that move in the waters, and of any slacking, and of any living thing which is in the waters, they shall be an abomination unto you.
Right? So it says, anything that doesn't have fins and scales that comes out of the water, it's an abomination to the fish. We can't eat it. Right? So she said, so the Lord said anything that doesn't have fins and scales, right? So meaning we can only eat fish that come out of the water, right? So we can eat salmon, right? Salmon got fins and scales, bass, tripe, I mean not tripe. That's a whole something else. What's it, trout, that's what I'm gonna say, trout, you know what I'm saying, fish like that, right, white, you know what I'm saying, fish that come out of the water that have scales, right, you can't eat the crab, you can't eat the lobster, you can't eat the shrimp, you can't eat the scallop, the oysters, you know what I'm saying, all of this stuff, all the weird shit, you see the Asians on TikTok, and eat. I don't know what the hell, eating all types of things, right? We ain't supposed to be eating that stuff, because it's unclean, right? A lobster and a shrimp, man, they basically sea roaches, right? Man, I seen a video yesterday of somebody pulling big-ass bugs out the water. Man, they were supposed to be like some type of shrimp. These motherfuckers look like some giant roly-polies. And they was about to eat them things, man. It's like, man, that's disgusting. What you gonna eat that for? Right? But they related to, they all related to each other. The shrimp is related to the damn roach. So that's a sea roach, man. Everybody out here, man, they think they eating shrimp, lobster and all that, man. They eating roaches in the water. They eating water bugs, man. Right? I know you've seen them big ass black things that be walking around the ground at nighttime, man. That's them cousins. That's their relatives, man. And our people wear that stuff. Right? It's a delicacy. They think it's one of the greatest things in the world that you can eat some shrimp, some lobster, some crab, man. And that's why the damn river looks like it's got it's all stained up and brown.
Hot.